students, today we are going to start chapter number 3, data handling for class 7th. As we learned about data handling in the class 6th also, so in continuation we will learn more about data handling. So let's begin with this. Let the attendance of your class, when the teachers take the attendance in your class, in his or her attendance register, so what will be the effect? Suppose the present of students in the month of April 2021, out of total 30 students is shown here for whole April month. So by observing this data, can you tell me on which date maximum number of students were present, or on which date the attendance is full, or all the students were present, or on which day the attendance is very less? Yes, we can give the answer, but not quickly we can give the answer. Okay. Let us consider one more example. Sale of any shop, if it is given in a year like 1,23,222, 1,60,000, 79,000, 99,990, like this, in a whole year the sale of the shop is given. So by observing this figure, can you tell me which month the sale is less, or the which maximum sale is in which month, or we can say which month sale is less? Or can we tell that by selling which item the shopkeeper earn more profit? For all these answers in both the examples, we need to arrange the given data. That means we have to organize the data in such a way that by observing that we can generate more and more meaningful results. So as we know, that data, that is the collection of informations like numerical facts, figures, values or numbers. It may be primary and secondary, as we know that the primary data, that is collected information through originally or first hand research, that means an observer collect the data himself or herself. These types of data are primary data, as surveys and focus group discussions. Similarly, the secondary data is what? It is the information which has been collected in the past by someone else, and we are referring from there. So these types of examples of the data is researching the internet, as we are searching something, any topic in internet, so that is the secondary data we are fetching it. Newspaper articles and company reports, all these are the secondary data. So here the data is very important in our day-to-day life. By that we can observe and give the results or some meaningful information about that particular organization, about the particular event or the particular classes. So by the data we can generate lots of information. For this we need to organize the data, that is we need to arrange the data. So it can be arranged in ascending order or descending order or alphabetically, or we can use the data in a tabular form also. In that we use the tally marks, as we learned this in the previous class. So let us take the weight of students in class as given like this. So for this, what we have to do, as we want to arrange this data systematically. So first of all, we have to observe this data given 28, 27, 29. The lowest value of this is 27 and the highest value is 30. So that means we have to make a table where weight is given, and we will mark the tally for this, and we will write how many times it occurs. So first is, as the observations are 27, 28, 29 and 30. So we have written at in this column weight. Now 27, if properly we will mark the tally, so it will not be incorrect or we will not miss any observation or any item. So let it do like this. First data is given 28, so cut it out and 28 is here, mark a tally. Then second data is 27, so mark a tally here. Then next data is 29, so mark a tally here, 29, in front of 29. Second next data is also 29, so mark a tally here again. Then 28, so mark the tally in the column of 28. Then 27, mark the tally mark here in the column of 27. Then next is 28, again mark the tally 28 here in the 28 column. 30, so it will be in the column of 30 kg. 27, so it will be in the 27 kg. 28, so it is here 28. Then it is 30, so it is in the 30. 29, so here it is 29. Then 30 again, so it will be in the 30 kg column, again 30, so again it is here. Then next data is again 30. So after making the four parallel lines, make the fifth line which cut all these lines like this. So this is the representation after four. Okay, so we have to make the tally marks like a group of these types of fives. Okay, then next is 27, so here it will be 27. Then it is 28, again 28. After 4, we have to make a line intersect all these 4 lines. Then next is 28, again here it is 28, and it is 29, so here it is 29, and then it is last data is 30, so the last observation 30 kgs. Now we have to count it all the tally marks. As we know, these 4 parallel lines and one is cutting all these 4, that means frequency is total 5. Here is again the 28 kg is 5, 29 kg is for 4, and again 30 is for 6. Now by arranging this data, that means it is the data for weight of students. So when we arrange this in this type of tabular representation, so by this we can give that maximum number of students or maximum number of children's weight is 30 kg, and minimum number of students are there 4 whose weight is 29. Okay, so like this we have to make the tally marks. So this tabular arrangement of the data is known as frequency distribution table. So this table what we are making here, this is known as frequency distribution table.